the 2010 Watch Night Service. Tonight we're preparing to enter into a worship experience like none other. Our worship experience will feature our male and female praise teams. To get started, we want to welcome the singing men of Carolina. Please put your hands together for Brother Chris Murphy. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh. y'all good? Shout neighbor. This is a good place right here for me to testify to the fact that I am not here on my own. Had it not been for my angels shielding and protecting me, if it had not been for the Holy Ghost letting me know where to go, where not to go, if it had not been for the Lord blocking every attack of the devil, I would have lost my life in 2010. But I'm still here because God. For 30 seconds. Somebody took your feet, look at your neighbor one more time and say, neighbor, this praise right here is for the stuff that I don't even know about. Say, God blocked it. Now give God some praise. Come on, everybody. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, y'all not ready to have no church in the house. Come on, come on. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Now I'm going to praise him in advance for 2011. I know he's going to block some stuff in 2011. So let me just go ahead and praise him in advance. Come on, come on. Everybody praise him. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm praising for my children.
Moments, we're going to cross over. God's going to come back and give us our finale. But I was just bothered by some of you all who act like you're supposed to be here. And it's only by the grace of God. I know all of y'all ain't church folks. Some of y'all stopped by the church on your way to the club. But I'm gonna help you while you're here. We gonna club here so you can club when you get back. If you don't know why you're clubbing in the first place, amen. I need to do something for a moment. I need to do something for just a moment. Our ushers are in position. I need to do something. I need you all to feel God in just a minute. I want to receive the tithe and the offering. There were those of my members. This is just for the members of this congregation. After I have preached, I want to give us an opportunity to sow a seed into 2011. But I want to talk to the membership of this ministry. The Lord allowed some inclement weather to come this way this past Sunday, and we were not able to receive the tithe and the offerings. And so what I need, I'm glad you're here tonight. And I want to make sure that I give you the opportunity to be blessed of God. Some of you have the capacity and you took the initiative to go online and to send your tithe. There were those of you who could not. And so right now, our ushers are in the aisles with envelopes. And this is just for the members of this congregation. Just for the members. I need you all to pay that tithe and your offering from last Sunday.
Just declare over your 2011. 2011 is going to be great for me. It's going to be great. It's going to be great. It's going to be great for me. It's going to be great for me. I'm telling the devil, I'm telling all his imps, I'm telling every demon in hell, 2011, it will not be like 2010. Some of the same mess I went through in 2010, I will see those demons no more. This is my time for victory. Says expect the great. Why don't you just say it one more time to your neighbor? Expect the great. 2011, expect the great. Come on, just put your hands together. Come on, come on. Thank you.
reach out and take the hand of your neighbor.
Second Samuel chapter 9.
Some of you all are techies and you have it on your phones, and some of you came with your iPads or your laptops. God bless you. Whatever you got to do to get it, just go and get it. Amen. Some of you came and you said, "Pastor, thy word have I hid in my heart." That's wonderful. I just can't trust your heart. It's going to be on the monitors in just a moment. I want to zero in around verse 3. I'm going to ask, before we begin to read, if you have, let me do this. The reason why we ask you to stand when we read the Word of God is because the Bible says that they stood in reverence of God's Word. And what I've determined is I will not give man more credence than I give to God. I know if President Obama, Barack Obama, walked in here, we would all be standing. But don't you let you give more credence to a man than you will to God. So if you have two legs and you're not in pain, and you can, I want you to stand wherever you are. Thank you, young people. Thank you. You see, there'll come a day when you'll wish you had a star. And I walk into hospitals and I see persons whose legs are being amputated, and they only wish that they could do it all over again. Preacher Baxter, good to see you, man. Bless you. 2 Samuel chapter 9. Let's begin reading in verse 3. And the king said, "Is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God unto him?" And Ziba said unto the king, "Jonathan have yet a son which is lame on his feet." And the king said unto him, "Where is he?" And Ziba said unto the king, "Behold, he's in the house of Machir, the son of Amiel, in a place called Lodabar." The king said, "Is there not any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God unto him?" And Ziba said unto the king, "Jonathan hath yet a son which is lame on his feet." And the king said unto him, "Where is he?" And Ziba said unto the king, "Behold, he's in the house of Machir, the son of Amiel, in Lodabar." I want to preach today from this subject, "Does anyone care?" Does anyone care? You might be seated. Does anybody care? Does anybody care? King David has just become the king of Israel. several chapters back, specifically in 1 Samuel chapter 16, around verse 13. David was anointed king, but he wasn't appointed king until 2 Samuel. Let me give that to you again. At the time of our text, King David has just become the king of Israel. Several chapters back, to be specific, in 1 Samuel, you will note that David is anointed king, but he wasn't appointed king until 2 Samuel. I've come to understand and to know that sometimes God will give you your anointing and then delay your appointing. But whatever God has anointed you for, God has the power to give you the placement of that anointment, which is the place God has for you. As the King of Israel, as the King of Israel, as the King of Israel, one of the first things that King David wanted to do was to bless the descendants of Jonathan. Jonathan was the son of King Saul. King Saul was king of Israel before David became king. Jonathan, being the son of King Saul, would then make him a prince. Jonathan and David were the best of friends. Are you with me so far?
Yes.
Let me go over it again. King Saul was king over Israel before David became king. Saul had a son whose name was Jonathan. Jonathan happened to have been best friends to David. So David and Jonathan were the best of friends. Now, had it not been for Jonathan and his loyalty to David, David would have had a harder time becoming king of Israel. At the time of our text, Saul is dead. Jonathan is also dead. David realizes that he probably would become king had it not been for Jonathan, who was the son of Saul. For those of you who do not know, Saul had a thing against David. He wanted David killed, but Jonathan, David's best friend, who happened to have been the son of Saul, warned his best friend about his daddy's scheme to have him killed. How am I doing so far? I want to make sure you follow me in this story. So then, David realizes that he probably would have never become king had it not been for Jonathan and his loyalty. So David is trying to figure out how can he pay back Jonathan when Jonathan is already dead. So David decides the way to pay Jonathan back is to bless his descendants. The problem with David's decision is that there has been wars and civil wars and so much unrest when it comes to Israel that locating any of Jonathan's descendants would be virtually almost impossible. So according to verse 3 of our text, watch verse 3. According to verse 3 of our text, David calls in Ziba. Ziba, you all, had been a servant to King Saul, and David calls him in and he asks Ziba this question. He says, are there any descendants left